I know we all love our guns, but sometimes it is nice to enjoy something gun-like without incurring the expense of ammo or maybe a lack of availability of a place to shoot. And that's why I wanted to show off my latest project. A little anticlimactic, I know. This here is my new PVC budget blowgun. Now, even though this is extremely cheap, you can't underestimate the fun of these. And it's extremely simple to make too. Basically, you get a piece of PVC pipe, cut it short enough to a length that you like. Now I'm going to show you a little demo later on of this, but also, of course, if you have a blowgun and you're making it yourself, you also need something to shoot out of it. I'll show you a little bit here on the darts I've got, which are simply modified Nerf darts. As you see here, basically what I've done is I'm using just regular Nerf darts for darts in the blowgun here. And now if you wanted to use one like this, unmodified, they shoot extremely great, probably better than any Nerf gun you're going to buy off the store shelf. So, you know, if you've got kids and maybe you just want to shoot around, this would be a good option. But maybe if you're a bigger kid, such as myself, maybe you want to try and up the ante a little bit. Now, in the construction of some of these more, I guess you could say, lethal darts, it's actually pretty simple. I've taken one of these darts apart, and like this is just a regular suction cup dart, and if you pull the foam part off, you can see that in the back side there is just a, you know, like a little rubber sleeve, and what that allows you to do is to stick some sort of hard projectile in there, whether it be a nail. I've even tried thorns off of an old thorny tree. They actually work pretty good. And all you got to do is stick it in there and poke it through the other end, pull it out, and you've got a fun dart that's going to stick in a lot of things. I've been experimenting a little bit with some different nails. This is more of a, I guess, a medium-sized nail. I think this actually works best. It's got the right amount of weight and probably gives you the best, I guess you could say, trajectory versus, you know, heft and power. These bigger nails also work quite well, but because of their heavier weight, you do have to blow a little harder to get them to travel as far and stick good. But they still work great. I've also experimented a little bit with this. This is a piece of a steel TIG welding rod, and sharpened it to a nice point there, and it actually works also pretty good. It is very lightweight though, so you may have to consider that. But you can get just about anything in here. Like I mentioned earlier, here's one with a thorn stuck through it. Don't even have to go to the hardware store if you've got a tree in your backyard or a bush or something. But that actually worked pretty good too. So, now that you see how easy it is to come up with this, let's see how it performs.
I can't see
it. Here I'm shooting the dart straight upwards. If you look towards the bottom left corner, you can see it shoot up here. You can also hear it come back down, whistling.
And it landed.
In this shot, I'm trying to shoot the dart that I made out of the thorn, hence the more forgiving cardboard target.
Not used front ends.
Now here is a close-up view of the exact same shot.
Oh, That's full penetration there. Look at that. That's some pretty thick cardboard too.
I'm gonna try a long shot here, see how far this dart can go. Now the target is the cardboard, off in the distance there.
Now on that shot I did not hit the actual target, but it kind of went off to the side down to the rotten wood in that shed there. You see me pick it up from the left side there. Here I try my hand at some small game hunting with a little toy stuffed squirrel. Notice how hard it impacted that squirrel. And how dead it would have been if it had been real. Now while that dart did not stick in that squirrel, it did make a nice cavity inside the stuffing. As you can see, the nail goes right into the side of it there. Now this poor little squirrel, I couldn't leave him alone. I decided to stick him up in a little tree and pretend to sneak up on him. And see if I could knock him out of that tree, just kind of get an idea of how much power that dart would have. Turns out it doesn't have that much if you miss your target. Okay, well, third time's a charm, right? Oh, I guess not quite.
Now I'm going too high.
I got a feeling I'm going to get it on this time. Standing further back, surely that's got to help.
Of course, you wouldn't carry something like that for me to hunt. Oh, first shot.
Poor squirrel. So hope you guys liked watching this blowgun video. I've only shown a fraction of the fun I actually had with it. So if you liked what you saw, subscribe. And this dart coming into frame is only 10% of real speed. Man, that looks like it hurt.